Little baby snakes! I have no idea how many this mama has. Look at this, guys. A bunch of babies. Ow! She's got my shirt. Stop! Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. It is snowing here in Michigan, and we are supposed to get about 6 inches of snow today, which I think is absolutely amazing. And I gotta tell you, it is much warmer here inside at BHV for sure. But again, we are getting a big snowstorm, our really biggest snowstorm of the year so far. But hey, I live in Michigan and there is gonna be snow because it is winter. And speaking of snow, I figured what I'd do just kind of to put that theme together is I'm gonna show you some animals that are snow animals. Things that have either snow in the name or white or whatever the case may be. I figured what the heck, it'd be kind of fun. I can show off some really cool snakes because I hope you guys like that. We're also gonna give you some update on Savannah, a bunch of the other animals. So it's going to be an amazing day, and I hope that you guys have an amazing day as well. What do you say we just set our problems aside and go ahead in the comments and let me know how your day is starting while you're down there. Smash that like button. Let's go ahead and start this snow apocalypse day right now. Let's go ahead and jump right into this, and I am going to start by talking about a snow Texas rat snake. And you guys are probably thinking, well, Brian, that certainly doesn't look like a snow of any sort. Well, I'm going to go ahead and start with the aneurythristic part, because that's where the story of the snow Texas rat really started for BHV, is the fact that just out of nowhere, we produced one of these guys here, which is aneurythristic, which is lacking the red pigment. Again, we didn't know anything about it. We were just breeding some Texas rat snakes, scaleless and leucistics, and out popped this kind of silvery animal. We thought, wow, that's kind of cool. Let's go ahead and raise it up. And after we raised it up, guess what happens? We bred them together and out popped a snow Texas rat snake. And again, a snow in most cases anyways would be the lacking of both red and black pigment. So that aneurythristic is lacking the red and then the albino is lacking the black. So you eventually get something that looks like a white snake. In this case, a white leucistic Texas rat. Now as babies, you can still see a little bit of the pattern, and this would be a little baby. And it's a feisty little monkey too. All it wants to do is bite me. And little Texas rat snakes typically have a pretty big attitude, but once they get bigger, they're really good, but you can kind of sort of see that it has a very faint pattern. So I figured we'll start the snow reptile theme day with the snow Texas rat. Now I'm going to take you guys back in history a little bit, because the fact is, the snake I'm holding right now was really the first snake that had the pleasure of being called a snow. And of course, this is a snow corn snake. And in the early days of reptile breeding, basically there wasn't a lot of mutations of animals. So when the snow corns were first produced, which again is an aneurythristic, amelanistic, lacking both the red and black pigment, these guys popped out and they were called snow corns. I'm gonna be totally honest with you, I don't know who produced the first ones, or I would tell you, and I don't know why they called them snow other than the fact that they're kind of white and that's a cool name. So really, this was the animal that started kind of the snow phase when it comes to breeding reptiles, and they're absolutely gorgeous. And of course, now we've been taking snow corns to like a different level here. This is what they would call a salmon or a coral snow, which is just basically that pink color instead of the white, because snow corns still have a little bit of pink in them. And this is a polygenic trait, just basically meaning you take the prettiest pink snake and you keep breeding them back together over and over. And every generation, the pink snakes get just a little bit more pink. And over many generations, you have this beautiful, almost fluorescent pink snake. All right, so now I'm gonna twist your brain a little bit, because I was talking about these beautiful, white looking, beautiful animals that are called snow. And one of the probably most popular snow reptiles is, believe it or not, a snow leopard gecko. That's right, this is a Mac snow leopard gecko. And you might be asking yourself, well, Brian, that doesn't look white at all. Why is that called a snow? And I'm not really exactly sure, other than the fact that it was definitely lacking a lot of the yellow pigment. But the fact is that when they hatch out, they're pretty much like almost like a black and white, or maybe even a dark brown and white leopard gecko. So John Mack, who produced the first Mac snows, is the one that called them a snow leopard gecko. And again, all these years later, you think, why was it that name? Maybe we could have came up with something better, but hey, once it's named, it's hard to really change it. But there you go, that is a snow leopard gecko. Well, if I'm gonna talk about snow leopard geckos, I might as well go through the progression really quick. This is what they would call a bold snow. And again, the bold is for that bold stripe. And you can see this one is definitely a lot less yellow. So you kind of see where, all right, it's a little bit of a snowy type thing. I don't know, that might be a stretch, but regardless, that's a bold snow. And then moving on, this would be a super snow animal. Again, super snow is certainly not super white, but it is a really cool animal. And oftentimes most people will say that the super snows are one of their favorite geckos, because I certainly think they really are. So they're absolutely amazing. So at least with this little monkey here, we're starting to get a little bit more white. This is actually a Tremper super snow white and yellow. And sometimes they hatch out almost all white. I'm not gonna say that John Mack, when he named the snow project, was like, oh, well, eventually you'll produce a super snow Tremper white and yellow that'll be almost white. Hey, it actually worked out. We're almost getting to an all white gecko when it comes to this animal here. And then there's this guy, which is really more on track. This is what they would call a blazing blizzard. So at least the blizzard is kind of like a snow. So, you know, hey, it's a blazing blizzard. And this one is almost white. You still see a little bit of yellow pigment, but when these are babies, these are really white. That's basically it when it comes to snow or white geckos. Well, I kind of figured if I'm going to show snow animals, maybe I'll show some white animals. I figure I'll show a blue-eyed leucistic ball python. Now, you guys that have been following me for any length of time realize that this is a white snake. That's a designer snake, and it's from what they call the blue-eyed leucistic complex. So there's a bunch of different ways to get these. You can breed lesser to lesser ball pythons. You can breed Mojave to Mojave, Mojave to lesser, Russo. There's a whole bunch of different combinations, but the end result is always this white snake with blue eyes. Now, some of them have a little bit of pattern, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of gray, but the fact is they're all absolutely amazing, and they are all pretty much snow white when they get to adult. And then there's the ivory ball pythons here, and you'll say, well, that's not really white, but when these guys get bigger, they're pretty much all white, but when they're babies, they hatch out with that kind of interesting head pattern and that yellow stripe down its back with a little bit of purple hues. I mean, I think they're absolutely amazing. And this was actually the first real white snake that was ever imported into the country and produced here in the country as well. So before the blue-eyed leucistics or black-eyed leucistics, the ivories were basically, ooh, you see that little silly monkey? The ivories are pretty much all that there was. And I tell you what, still all these years later, I think they're absolutely amazing. And what the heck? I might as well throw piebalds in there too. And I realize they are not an all white snake, but they are absolutely amazing. And whenever I can show off a piebald ball python, I'm like, I'm gonna do it. So the fact is, if I'm talking about anything with white, these are absolutely the whitest of anything we produce. I mean, really the pies are even whiter than the leucistics, in all honesty. They are pure white. And with that pattern with them as well, it really makes them pop. Okay guys, I'm done talking about white snakes and snow snakes. The fact is that we are bracing for a big snowstorm today, and I just thought it would be kind of fun. Now we're back to our normal scheduled vlog. And I'm gonna go ahead and start the normally scheduled vlog with something exciting, people, and that's baby snakes. That's right, little baby snakes. I have no idea how many this mama has. Oh my gosh, this is an aneurythristic Kenyan sambo. Look at mama. Mama, what's going on? Did you have a bunch of babies? Look at the cute little baby right there. Oh, I cannot wait to see what she had. Oh, look at this, guys. A bunch of babies. Oh my God, how freaking awesome is that? Okay, let's go ahead now. You gotta remember that mamas are usually pretty upset when they're just done. And I don't know why they're upset. If they're either protecting their babies or they're just hungry, I'm not sure what it is. But regardless, we're gonna go ahead and pull these baby snakes. Baby Kenyans, I am so excited. All right, here, ooh, gotta stay away from that business end there, mama. Okay, mama, it's okay. Oh, it's okay. Okay, here we go. Here's the first one right here. Here we go, there's one little baby. And you can see they're still so chubby with all that yolk in them. Here's two little babies. Oh gosh, how many do you think you're gonna have? Go ahead and comment down below as I'm collecting. How many babies do you think this mama's gonna have? All right, so we've got two so far. Oh, she is mad. Come on, mama. It's okay. Okay, this is the third baby. Four babies. Five little babies. Okay, here we go. Whoop. There's six. Seven. Ooh, I'm gonna get bit. Seven. Come on, little guys. Eight. Nine. There's 10. We've got 10 babies so far. We still have some more to go. Come on, mama. It's okay. There's 11. Okay. 11 so far. Is that it? Ow! She's got my shirt! Stop! Let go! Oh my gosh, she's crazy. I told you, you gotta watch out for those guys. All right, 11. It looks like 11 is it, guys. Okay, so 11 little babies. Take a look at these cute little monkeys right here. Look at how beautiful. And again, this is aneurythristic, which is a recessive mutation. So both the mom and dad were aneurythristic, and you have all these beautiful little black and white baby Kenyan sambos. How freaking awesome is that?
Well, hey guys, I just figured that I would go ahead and give you a Savannah update. Savannah/Speedy update, because this guy here
really likes his new friend.
I just wanted to let you know how she's doing. Actually, we're super happy. I gotta find her. She's cruising around all over the place. She's definitely feeling more like home, so we're super happy about that.
As you can see, she's just cruising around, figuring out her new digs. She's super friendly and loves to just come up and hang out with us. Yeah, she is definitely a sweetheart.
And we are super happy to have her here. Also, on a side note, I was cracking up earlier because, again, we're keeping a close eye, making sure she's not getting harassed or anything too bad by Speedy, which, again, here he comes.
wherever she is, he seems to come not far behind.
But it is pretty funny. She's moving around now. She's running away if she doesn't want to be by him, or even kind of, I wouldn't say fighting back, but pushing back. You know, if he comes and she doesn't want anything to do, I've come around the corner and she was literally, you know, pushing him. So I like to see that she's just not sitting back and taking all his crap. She's saying, no, you know what? You're not going to push me around. And if I don't want to be by you, you're not going to be by me. I really like her attitude, and
I'm really happy that she's definitely feeling more comfortable here.
I like her no-nonsense attitude. She's like, you know what, Speedy? I ain't taking your crap. Move along. And
there he goes, moving along.
So today's vlog is going to end the same way it began, in the snow. We are going to get a ton of snow today, and I absolutely think it's amazing. And I hope that you guys enjoyed this vlog, the kind of craziness of the snow morphs and all the other stuff. You guys mean the world to me, and your support is incredible. I love you so much. So I am going to have fun in the snow, and I hope that you guys have fun the rest of your day or evening or whatever it happens to be. Can you do me a couple favors before we go, please? Can you smash that like button as well as hit that post notification bell so that you know when I upload a video, which is every day, 7 days a week, 9 o'clock in the morning, Eastern Standard Time. Remember to be kind to somebody today, and I promise I'm going to see you guys tomorrow.